Today is Friday, July 22nd. It's been 59 days since Skiff received MRI and CT scan requests and all that other shit. Still haven't heard anything back. I still have not heard anything from the Workers' Compensation Appeals Board outside of a call from Dino on Monday morning, which was, "Hey, where are you? You're not here." No shit. You didn't send me any fucking notice, douchebag fucking Workers' Compensation Appeals Board and State Compensation Insurance Fund. I mean, really, you guys are a fucking problem that everyone has to deal with. And it's not fair. The fucking post office does not work well enough to do what you want it to do, when you want it to do it. And that even includes you sometimes, possibly, but I don't know, because I still haven't received any kind of notice. And only a month ago, it took about a month or so for where I live to even receive my fucking rent check. So, why should I even bother to rely on the fucking post office for communications, legal or unwise? What's the fucking point? They lose shit, it's gone, there's no trail. The paper trail is gone, because the paper is what is the message. There's no path, you can only guess. Know what machine it might have been through. There's no serial number, there's no timing, there's no packets. Sure, you can label your parcel part one of two, but that's just as easy to lose or not get resent. But that's just the thing about the internet, how well it works. You send something in it, the person on the other end doesn't get it, depending on how you sent it, what kind of protocol you use, they may or may not reply. It also depends on their firewall situation and whatever else they might be doing. But nonetheless, much more instantaneous, much more acknowledgeable. And yet, the state and the State Compensation Insurance Fund choose to fuck over people how they want, when they want, any way they want. Because that's what they do. They don't care about the person who's injured on the job. It's pretty fucking evident. I started the QME panel process way back in 2004. It's 2011. They fucking delayed and denied the shit out of everyone I chose, to the point where the guy that I ended up with and yada 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 doesn't get any more QME credentials, therefore isn't able to write a report. Now it's strange because all these doctors that I find by myself or otherwise are sympathetic, if anything, and yet the ones directed to provide me care by Skiff, well, not really care, but provide reports on their bag. Anyway, we'll pay attention to the freeway for right now. I'm done ranting. At least about my fucking workers' comp shit. Which is not gonna fucking end anytime soon, which is apparent, because, well, 4 days it'll be fucking 10 years since I got hurt on the job, and I haven't had a pain-free day since. And that's fucking sad, and it makes me very sad all the fucking time. Especially when I have to deal with the fucking workers' compensation system by myself, because I am unable to get a lawyer. Because if I were to get a lawyer at this point, I would have to start all over again with all of the medical bullshit, which is part of the problem. more douchebags do not need to get paid more money to fucking waste their time for shit that I already know is not going to go away anytime soon, that I am able to deal with and receive relief through the use of medical cannabis. But instead, business and the insurance industry and etc. don't give a fuck. They just want to cut you off, rip out your fucking teeth, and then sit in front of you with their goddamn blinker on, not paying attention, because that's what they fucking do. They just take their goddamn overpriced checks and then sit in your face and pretend like everything is all right, but it's not. They don't give a fuck. I mean, who'd have thought? The doctor cuts me off and it leads to a really good brand. It's pretty cool, I guess. Great signal. Surprised you passed medical school, but then again, you are a dentist. Dentist! You rip out teeth for a living. You don't save lives exactly, although people do need teeth to eat. You're still a fucking douchebag. I mean, really, if there was ever a social or servant than that, it would definitely be a dentist or their child on the phone in the fucking carpool lane. Oh, never mind. She's got a baby in the back. But still, you're on your phone! You're on your phone! Stupid people. I mean, hell, I'm having a fucking podcast while I'm on the freeway, but still. That's just me having a conversation with myself or whoever might be in the car with me. Not driving around going, "Hello, how are you today? I hope you're having a good day, Gamma. Okay, see ya." I mean, come on. People, this is not where we need to be. Not where we need to be. Say it with me. This is not where we need to be. On the freeway, driving around aimlessly. Everyone else driving around freely as well, possibly not paying attention. What's the fucking point? I guess you like paying people all your money that you earn for the privilege of feeling the thrill of going, "Woo!" Should just go to fucking Knott's Berry Farm. Yeah, just go to Knott's Berry Farm, ride a roller coaster. Sit in line, enjoy yourself. Life does not have to be a roller coaster of riding on a freeway. In fact, it would be much safer if we were on tracks, like a roller coaster. Wow. Who'd have thought? I wish I had a better microphone on this fucking camera already, but felt like modifying it. No, probably shouldn't drive on that line. Just saying. I can understand that you're trying to get into the carpool lane, but you probably shouldn't just drive on the line for whatever reason. It's kind of an expensive ticket. Leaving the carpool lane, that's one thing. Psychologist's office, a therapy session on. Last one that's authorized. It's been about 3 weeks. And yeah, I mean, the system has not really gotten any better at all. In fact, it just seems to press its thumb on my fucking forehead even more to tell me how much it's not gonna fucking give a fuck about my life and push me around and discriminate upon me. And I mean, that's kind of the same shit I was dealing with 10 years ago when they were age discriminating me at fucking Nymatic Interfaces, which is bullshit. And then, yeah, I mean, it's fucking ridiculous. I mean, only one person ended up having my back there, and I consider him a friend today. I probably have not seen him since I got hurt, before I got hurt. But, you know, the internet does make it possible for people to stay in touch and communicate easily, which is cool. That's kind of what the internet was about. Communication, sharing of information, freedom. Even though it was developed for military purposes, for redundancy and whatnot, for military communications, it still serves quite a good purpose for everyday consumers. And even serves a good use for business. But, you know, businesses like to abuse their technological power and such, especially when it comes down to financial will and imposing upon that. Stupid fucking 55 freeway interchange bullshit. Every fucking time. I know you want to get over, but you're just scared. I understand. You're crazy fucking people driving around in big fucking cars, not really paying too much attention. You've only been a good driver and kept your blinker on for like a quarter mile, which is cool. I understand. I just want to go there. Not even there, I just want to go there. But I have to deal with all that. It's fucking disgusting. I didn't know where I got this Scottish accent. Or whatever the hell it comes from. Maybe Australian. But... no, you look like you're about to do something sneaky. As you can see, if you want to go to Newport Beach during the summertime, you're kind of fucked. Kind of fucked. Oh, I just want to get over. Come on, motherfucker. Death trap! Here I am, driving around. Might be a possibly fucking cracked neck. Again, just to reiterate, 59 days. In fact, if you want to say hi, state compensation insurance fund, you can just wave to them. They'll be up here on the right-hand side. In fact, they're this giant fucking building that you can see whenever I turn my head to that side. And unfortunately, I'm in the crosswalk. I feel bad, but there's a sign blocking my way, so I can't exactly see when I'm supposed to yield or not. Anyway, there's Skiff. Pricks. I guess we'll have a dance break. Psychologist, whatever, therapy, talk therapy, good stuff.